Welcome to ITFreeTraining's free course on Active Directory. In this video, I will be looking at the Active Directory migration tool, otherwise known as ADMT. Do you remember that email that was forwarded around entitled, "How to Know If You're Living in the 90s? One of the lines was, "You know you work in corporate America in the 90s if you've sat at the same desk for 4 years and worked for three different companies." It is common in business for companies to change names, companies to be bought and sold, and restructures to happen. The ADMT tool allows you to quickly move and copy objects around Active Directory to quickly meet the needs of the business. In this video, I will look at using ADMT 3.2 on Windows Server 2008 R2 member server. It is important to understand the prerequisites of any software, and in particular, ADMT. If you attempt to install ADMT on an unsupported operating system, you may have unexpected results. Microsoft has released an ADMT migration guide. This document contains all the prerequisites for ADMT and instructions on how to install ADMT. ADMT requires SQL Server to provide a database. In this case, I will use SQL Express 2008 with Service Pack 1. If you have a SQL Server on your network, you can use this install to hold the ADMT database. It is also possible to install ADMT on a domain controller. When we attempted to install it on a domain controller, we had to implement a workaround to get ADMT to work correctly. Although it can be done, it is easier to install ADMT on a member server. In summary, read the prerequisites for ADMT carefully. In some cases, you may encounter errors during the install. If this is the case, hopefully Microsoft has released a workaround to fix these problems. Before I start looking at how to install and use the ADMT tool, I will first look at some concepts and terminologies that you should be aware of before you start moving objects around Active Directory. The first term is inter-forest migration. This is when the source domain and target domain are in different forests. As shown here, the domain IT-free-training and high-cost-training are separated by a forest trust. The domains could be separated by another trust type. The important thing to remember is that when the domains are not part of the same forest, the migration is considered to be inter-forest migration. To put it another way, each domain is part of a different Active Directory environment, and thus has its own Active Directory schema. The next migration type is intra-forest migration. This is when the source and target domain are in the same forest. As shown here, secure.itfreetraining.local is a child domain of itfreetraining.local. In this case, migrations from between these two domains would be considered intra-forest migrations. The easy way to remember is if both names share the same schema, they are intra-forest. If they do not, they are inter-forest. The next concept I want to look at is Sid history. To understand Sid history, it helps to look at the process of migrating a user from the source domain to the target domain. As you can see here, the user exists in the source domain, and the administrator wants to move that user to the target domain. In order to migrate the user to the target domain, a new user needs to be created in the target domain with the same username. You can see here that when the new user is created in the target domain, the new user is given a new SID for the target domain. What this means is that the new user in the target domain will not be able to access any resources in the old domain. As shown here, the new user in the target domain will not be able to access a file share in the old domain. This is because the file share permissions were set using the SID from the old user account. Essentially, Active Directory sees the user in the target domain to be a completely new user and does not recognize any of the permissions that user was given before. To get around this, you could simply change the access of the file share, giving the new user in target domain access. If you consider when performing most migrations, you want to remove the old domain when it is no longer required. The administrator simply wants to allow the user access to resources in the old domain until these resources can be moved out of this domain and the domain is eventually decommissioned. This may not always be the case. In some cases, the user may be moved from a different domain due to job changes. Whichever is the case, the migration should not involve having to change a lot of permissions or groups in order to maintain the level of access the user had in the old domain. To get around this problem, migration can make use of Sid History. Sid History keeps a record of the SIDs that were associated with that user in the old domain. In this example, when the new user is created, the SID for that user in the source domain is copied into the SID history for the new user. When the user logs into the new domain using the new user, a security token is created for that user. This security token contains the new user SID and also the SIDs in the SID history. This essentially means that the security token can be used to access resources in that domain and any resources in the old domain. Now that all the theory is out of the way, I will now change to my Windows Server 2008 R2 member server to look at how to install and use ADMT. I do not have any SQL servers installed on this network, so the first thing that I need to do is download SQL Express with Service Pack 1. To find the download page, I will perform a search in Google. SQL Express is a free standalone, cut-down version of SQL Server. SQL Express provides basic database functions for applications, but does not offer many features that the commercial SQL Server offers. In the case of ADMT, I only need a database to store migration information, so SQL Express will work well for this. The first result is SQL Server 2008 R2 with Service Pack 1. Even though this server is running Windows Server 2008 R2, the SQL Express server that I will download is SQL Server 2008 with Service Pack 1. This will allow me to demonstrate a workaround that can be used to get this version to work with Windows Server 2008 R2. I will now perform a Google search for ADMT. The first result is ADMT 3.2, which is the version that I'm going to install. Notice down in the list is the ADMT guide. This is a guide on how to use ADMT to migrate objects between different domains. It is a very detailed document supplied by Microsoft to assist you with your migration, so it is worth downloading. The ADMT guide, SQL Express, and ADMT 3.2, which have just been downloaded, will all be saved to the desktop. I will now install SQL Express first, as ADMT will not install until it has a SQL database to use. Since this version of SQL Express was not designed for Windows Server 2008 R2, you may get some errors like this one. When setup runs, it decompresses the files to the C drive and will have issues reading them. To get around this, I will open Windows Explorer and copy the decompressed setup files to the desktop. When I press OK on the error message, the temporary files will now be removed. You can also extract the install files using decompression software. If I now run setup from the desktop using the decompressed files, this time it will launch without any issues. To start the install, I will select Install from the left, and then select the option New SQL Server Standalone Installation or Add Features to an Existing Installation. The first screen will check for any problems that may prevent SQL Express from installing correctly. Once past this screen, SQL Express will go to the Product Key screen. Since this is the free version, I do not need to enter in a product key and I can press Next. The next screen will ask to accept the license, which I will do. Following that, setup will ask which features to install. As there is only one option, I will press Install. Setup will now install SQL Express. Once the install has been completed, some configuration needs to be done. The first screen will run a number of tests to confirm that other components required by SQL Express are set up correctly. In this case, setup has detected that the Windows firewall is not set up correctly. In this case, I will only be using ADMT on the local computer and not over the network, and thus the firewall does not need to be configured correctly. The next screen will ask which features need to be installed. In this case, I only need basic database support, so I only need to select the first option, Database Engine Services. The next screen determines the instance configuration, which is used to identify this install of SQL Express. In this case, I can accept the default and move on. On the next screen, I need to configure a service account for SQL Express to use. Since I am only using this database locally, I will choose the option to run the database engine using the system account. The next screen will ask for a user to be added that will be responsible for administration of the SQL install. In this case, I will add the current user and move on. The next screen asks for usage and reporting. I will skip this screen and move on. The next few screens will confirm what options have just been done and install the files required for SQL Express. Once the installation is complete, I can make my way to the end of the wizard and close setup. Now that SQL Express is installed, I will now run the setup for ADMT. Once I am past the Welcome, License, and Customer Experience screen, I will be asked to enter in the database that ADMT will use. In this case, I will enter in /SQL Express to indicate the local SQL Express install. ADMT will now be installed. Setup will give you the option to import data from an existing MDMT database. In this case, the ADMT install was a fresh install, so I will not import anything. Once I finish the wizard, I will now be able to run the Active Directory Migration tool from Administrative Tools under the Start menu. In this example, I will import some users from the high-cost training domain. The IT-free training domain and high-cost training domain are separated by a forest trust and thus are completely different Active Directory deployments. You could also use the ADMT tool to move users around domains in the same forest. To start the migration, right-click Active Directory Migration Tool and select the option User Account Migration Wizard. You will notice there are also wizards available for migration for groups, computers, and other Active Directory objects. Once past the welcome screen, enter in the source and target domain. In this case, the source domain will be High Cost Training, and the target domain will be IT-Free Training. This means that the user for High Cost Training domain will be migrated to the IT-Free Training domain. On the next screen, you have the option to select which users you want to migrate. When you are migrating hundreds of users, it is worth your time to look into the second option, Read Objects from an Include File. This option will read the users that need to be imported from a file rather than the administrator having to manually select which users are to be migrated. Once on the next screen of the wizard, I can choose which users that I want to migrate. In this case, I will migrate the user John Doe and John Brown. Once you have selected the users that you want to migrate, the next screen of the wizard will ask which organizational unit these migrated users will be put into. Once you have selected the OU the users will be put into, the next screen will ask the type of passwords that will be used. The default option will generate complex passwords for the user. The next option, Migrate Passwords, requires Password Export Server to be installed on the domain controller that you are migrating the users from. If you're going to use this option, ensure the version of ADMT that you install supports the version of Password Export Server that has been installed on that domain controller. If you do decide to migrate passwords, remember that even if the passwords from the other domain do not meet password requirements for the new domain, they will still be migrated. When the password expires in the new domain, the user will be forced to choose a password that meets the new password complexity requirements for the new domain. It is up to you to decide if this is a security risk. The location for where new passwords are stored is now visible at the bottom of the screen. If you decide to use complex passwords, this file has the new passwords for that user. You need to read to obtain the password and pass this on to the user. On the next screen, you will need to configure the status of the account that will be created after it is migrated. The default is same as source. This means that if the account was disabled, it will be disabled when it is migrated. If the account was enabled, it will also be enabled in the new domain after migration. You also have the option to choose if you want the accounts to be disabled or enabled after the migration. This gives you the option of what should happen in the source domain. If you do not want the user to log in to the old domain after the user account has been moved, tick the option Disable Source Accounts. This option is useful during migration. It also enables you to expire the account after a certain number of days. This allows the user to log back into the old domain if there is a problem, but prevents them from using their user account in the old domain indefinitely. The option at the bottom, Migrate User SIDS to Target Domain, should be selected for when a user is still using resources in the old domain after migration. This will store the user's previous SIDS in the new user's account's SID history. When accessing resources, Windows is now able to work out the new account is the same person as the old account using the user's SID history. The next screen of the wizard allows you to configure options on how the user is migrated. The option Translate Roaming Profiles means that if a roaming profile is used in the other domain, this roaming profile will be copied to the new domain. The next option, Update User Rights, will attempt to configure the user with the same user rights that they had in the previous domain. The following option, Migrate Associated User Groups, allows you to migrate any user groups that are missing and required in the new domain. To have a smoother migration, an administrator will normally migrate user groups first using the Group Migration Wizard. This will allow them to correct any issues beforehand. Remember that different groups will have different scopes, so this could affect the migration being successful. The last option, Fix User Group Memberships, will attempt to make the users members of the same groups that they were a member of in the old domain. To do this, ADMT will look for groups of the same name in the target domain. The next screen of the wizard will now ask if any particular properties of the user are not to be migrated. You can see there are a lot of options here. For example, if the users are being moved from one office to another, you may decide not to migrate information about the location of the user, such as their office and company address, since this will now be incorrect. The next screen asks what to do if there is a conflict. On large networks, there is a good chance that two users will have the same username. The default option will be to not migrate the object when there is a conflict. The second option gives you several different options to choose from for when the user already exists in the target domain. That's it for all the options. Once the wizard is complete, you will find that all users have now been migrated. To ensure that all users have been migrated correctly, select the button at the bottom, View Log. This will open the log file showing you how the migration went, which options were used, and at the bottom, you can see that the two users that I selected have been migrated correctly. This covers the basics of the Active Directory migration tool. For the Active Directory exam, you will only require a basic understanding of how to use the ADMT tool. Thanks for watching another free video from IT Free Training. See you next time.